my goodness. Oh, fuck the sun. Hello, hello, hello. My name is Closer Dave. Welcome back. Do I want to skip the tutorial case? Nah, I'm good. I'll do it. Why not? And welcome back to La Noire. Last time we completed the game, the ending's a little disappointing.
A new type of city, based not on the man, but on the automobile, the car.
Very, very fun game, and we're going to get back into it now. And, yeah, we're going to be going for our retreat.
Where every man can own his own home, and have room to breathe.
We are going to be focusing on murder with different guns. Stealing people's vehicles,
the city where a man's home is his castle,
doing street
a quarter acre of the dream made possible by victory.
And there's a couple of little individual trophies for particular cases, which we're going to do our best. But primarily, we're just going to cause chaos as per usual.
The city of dreams, where Hollywood will shape the thoughts and desires of the entire planet. City of pioneers.
It's actually so awesome.
A city of dreamers. City of undercurrents, where not everything is as it seems. A 20th century city that will become a model for the world. A city that has no boundaries, that will stretch as far as the eye can see. In the Marine Corps, you deal with the chain of command. Mistakes get made, but you deal with them. You know what you're fighting for and that you're on the same team. But dealing with corruption is like chasing shadows. You never know whether the guy you're talking to is on the pad, or whether it's your partner, or maybe even the watch commander. So who do you trust, Cole? I made up my mind a long time ago.
KGBL calling car, 14 Adam. 14 Adam, come in.
Go ahead, KGPL.
14 Adam, see the detective and ambulance shooting at 6th and Industrial Street.
We'll deal with that.
16 William requests uniform assistance for an evidence search. 14 Adam, code 2.
Roger, 14 Adam, en route. Here we... Careful!
In my defense.
Here we go again. They don't request uniforms for an evidence search unless there's some...
I thought it was there. We got here as fast as we could, officer.
Floyd Rose, homicide. You might back up?
Yes, sir.
Floyd Rose,
Phelps and Dutch,
nice
Wilshire Division. We had a shooting took place down this alleyway. We have the Vic, Scooter Payton, a Negro male bagged up and on his way to Central Morgue.
Cool.
Witness says a tall white guy, our shooter, put two in the Vic's head and then threw his piece.
Okay.
I need you guys to try and recover the gat.
You want us to look anywhere in particular?
Give it your best shot, guys. The dead guy's a lowlife. I'm not expecting any miracles here.
And if we recover the weapon?
Bag it and return it to technical services.
You hurry it up, Floyd. We've got places to be.
Happy hunting.
On it, bitch.
This is a fist hump. Just going through the motions.
You're probably right. Let's just get it over and done.
All right, have it your way. We'll search right up to the back wall. If you still don't come up with anything, come find me and we'll talk it out. Two heads are always better than one.
Two heads are better than one. It's double the pleasure, baby. It's triple the fun. I say two heads are
look
better
at this junk.
Than one. To make you come undone. Two heads are better than one.
Dr. Fontaine, could I have a word?
Of course, young man.
I really enjoyed your lecture, Doctor.
So I know.
Psychiatry seems to have a tremendous amount to offer.
Why, thank you. I'm always happy to receive acknowledgement for my work. The mind is the last great mystery in medicine. Are you thinking of specializing, Mr.
Sheldon, or Courtney Sheldon? I'm only in second year, doctor. They fast-tracked me a year because of my experience during the war.
Ah.
That's what I wanted to talk to you about. Battle fatigue and collapse under duress. Can it be helped?
I would say yes, given the right set of circumstances. Trauma forces the mind to close down, retreat in on itself. We try to find ways to unlock the mind again through a combination of therapy and drug treatment. Hypnosis and therapy are powerful tools in the right hands, Chef.
I've been to visit some of the guys at the VA hospital. A good friend of mine, he's so far away. It's like he's wandering
around. You went through a lot together.
Yes, Doc.
Give me his details and I'll make a prognosis. I have a number of clinics in Los Angeles, Courtney Sheldon. And your penance, for your friend's help, is to come and work at one of them in your spare time. With what little spare time a medical student has. Is that a deal?
Is it ever? I can't thank you enough.
I'm not promising a cure, Courtney. I want you to remember that. Every physician has patients that he cannot hope to cure, for whom he can only smooth the path to death.
What a cheery lad.
It's not my job to pick through other people's trash.
Yeah, what is your job? Wait, you're a cop. That's, I mean, not exactly your job, but it's not exactly not your job.
What have you got, Phelps? Appear? Anything?
I don't know.
Jesus. Cole, come take a look at this.
Hold on. I'm exploring.
I tell you, I'm jinxed. I always get landed with this crap.
Interesting. There's fuck all up here.
We're never gonna find it. It's a waste of time.
Never gonna find what? Hello. What did you see? Is it this jam on the wall?
Shooter put him up against the wall and blew his brains out.
My god, man.
Hell of a way to go.
Nasty way to go.
Doesn't really matter how you go once you're gone.
Don't get all deep on me, Phelps.
No, I wasn't threatening you.
Ralph, there's something on the rooftop.
How the hell did you see that?
Reflection in the window. Looks like it might be our weapon. I'm gonna see if I can find a way up there.
All right, don't hurt yourself.
Oh, I will.
The gun's up on the roof, right?
Yeah.
So we need to find a way up.
I know what we have to do. I'm just being nosy. Is that all right with you?
What kind of chumps do these homicide guys think we are?
Beat cops.
Smith & Wesson, serial S7189.
I found the gun. Yes. Two rounds fired,
and instead of dropping it down a drain, our shooter hoists it up here. Interesting guy.
And now I have a gun.
We should follow up on this now, before the perp tries to leave town.
We have the gun, Cole. Let's take it back to Central. We could get a commendation.
Could show some initiative, Ralph, and see if we can come up with an owner.
That's a long shot, Cole.
It's a pretty fancy gun. You know a local gun store?
Sure. There's a place a couple of blocks from here.
All right, let's do it. Let's go.
Are you sure about this? It's not really our gig.
No harm in doing some digging. The suits didn't seem to give much of a damn.
Such a little Boy Scout, Cole. You can't wait to get out of that uniform, can you?
Nope.
You'd rather round up drunks and help old ladies across the road?
I'd rather get through the day without the captain's foot up my ass.
It'll be fine, Ralph. You worry too much.
I need your car.
Please get out of the car, miss.
Am
this is an emergency.
Am I under arrest?
You should be. Don't fucking test me.
This is KGI, a member of the
You coming? Oops. My bad. I accidentally got out. I didn't want to do that. Zhong. Zhong. Zhong.
I hope they didn't get our number, Phelps.
Of course they did. Don't worry. About a thing. Cause every little thing is gonna... I'm in America. Don't worry. About a thing. Cause every little thing is gonna be alright. Oh, baby.
Careful! Say...
Don't worry. About a thing. Cause every little thing is gonna be alright. Oh, baby.
Have you got a death wish?
You've helped quite enough.
There was a lot in that mailbox. We sell ammo. We're under arrest.
Officers Phelps and Dunn, can you tell us anything about this gun?
Smith & Wesson, Model 27, registered Magnum.
I knew that.
Chambered for .357, nickel-plated with pearl grips.
Okay.
Same gun used by General Patton.
You're not suggesting he's the owner?
No, I'm not.
You seem to know a lot about the weapon.
I ought to. I sold it. You know, this piece will stop a rhino. These babies are only available special order. Here's my Smith & Wesson order book.
You mind if I take a look?
Be my guest.
Super.
This is about something bad, right?
I'm murder.
Model 27 with pearl grips, Cole. You see it on there?
Yep. Found it.
We're in luck. Errol Schroeder, 203 South Gless Street. Ordered the gun in February 46. Thanks, you've been a big help.
Thank
Anytime.
You. You sell any more guns?
Always happy to help out the LAPD.
I'm sure you are. Is there anything in here that I might arrest you for? I've never actually looked around the place after getting help. There's stairs here. What is down here? A shooting range? Oh. Stepped on your bucket, sorry. Okay. That's kinda cool.
Junk.
So mean. Let me just pick up your duck and then call you.
Can we call
loser.
It in?
No,
let's see if he's at home. Owning the gun doesn't prove he pulled the trigger.
Okay. In for a penny, in for a pound.
Get your ass out the car, man.
Be careful with it, copper.
I will not be careful with it. That's
out of the car. Police.
Yeah, Hey, it connects the cars from my previous playthrough. I didn't fucking know that. Alright, let's go! That should make this a little bit easier. Oops, that's not a pathway I can cross, excuse me!
God damn it, Cole!
Don't worry, I need to do like a handbrake turn here, but I'm not going to do a handbrake turn. I'm just gonna turn! Alright, well,
now that wasn't so hard, was it? Just because we're in uniform doesn't mean we can't use our initiative.
I guess so. Seems a little too good to be true. One-of-a-kind murder weapon bought locally using a real name? If Schroeder's our shooter, he's no criminal mastermind.
Most of them aren't. That's why they get caught.
Alright, have it over!
What are you doing to this car?
I'm taking a shortcut, pal.
Hold on.
Most of them aren't. That's why they get caught. Two out of every three crimes are done on impulse.
Another fact from the Phelps Encyclopedia of Thin Air. You really are full of it. Slow down!
I know what I'm doing.
I don't feel like that was my fault, though. You know? I feel like, if anything, you were the one with the map. Car.
Fine, but if the skipper sees us driving around in this, we're dead.
Why? Why? Okay, now if we hit someone this turn. Beep beep!
Are you blind?
No, I just expected it to break, that's all. I don't think I'm the crazy one. That guy did not get a fuck if he died.
Arm.
No, I'm arresting someone. I'm a hero. Okay, go, 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 go. Bonk. Two.
Schroeder, Harbin 2.
You're under arrest, pal.
What do you guys want?
I'm Officer Cole Phelps. This is Officer Dunn, Wilshire Division. You're the owner of a Smith & Wesson Model 27, nickel-plated with pearl grips?
I might be. What of it?
Then you'll be surprised to know that Scooter Payton was murdered tonight with your gun.
You're out of your mind. Scooter? He works for me.
Okay.
I have that gun here in my drawer.
Great. You know the victim.
What the fuck is going on here?
You're under arrest, Schroeder. Cuff him, Ralph.
No way. You're not taking me down for this.
Ralph.
You ready, tough guy?
I'm ready, bitch. I'm ready. I think the game's waiting for me to learn to block.
Ralph, you all right?
I'm fine. I hardly felt it.
Of course you did.
Lucky you caught me off guard.
Your ass for like 18 days. Okay. Yeah.
Keep an eye on him, Ralph. I'm gonna take a look around.
You point your gun at him, man. You don't want him getting the jump on you again. Oh, Ralph. He doesn't have anything here. Although he has a comic, which is mine now.
To be fair. Help.
Although I'm glad we've put this man in jail. He keeps his apples on the
floor.
I don't
think this is any use to us.
Marty, Rosemary Summers, Frank Clayton, Ted Kaplan, F. Green, Leroy. These dates? There must be dates. Dolby, Thedor, Woody Wallace, Floyd.
List of names and a series of numbers. Floyd Rose's name is in this book.
Phelps, we can come out of this all bright and shiny with a commendation. Or stick our schlongs in a hornet's nest. Call it in, partner.
Look.
And leave the book where you found it.
Shame me, man, all right?
Officer Phelps, badge 1247.
Joy.
You dumb fucking sons of bitches! Get in this line now before I lose my temper!
Excuse me, Sergeant, but...
Excuse me? Fuck you! You say another word and I'll break your fucking head and have you in the brig!
Some of us are here for...
I know why you're here, asswipe!
Just here for the fish.
I'm having a bad day, Private.
Welcome to the...
Some people don't seem to want to get on this bus.
I didn't ask for your help.
He didn't ask for your help. Can you believe this guy? Who are you two? Abbott and Costello?
We're here for OCS, Sergeant.
So it's the three fucking stooges and you're here for OCS. God help this fucking country and the USMC.
Oh, yeah.
The Japanese will do the world a favor and kill you quickly. All three of you are on report. What are your fucking names?
Well, I don't answer rude people.
Merrill.
Any other gentlemen for OCS? OCS is at Elliott. You take the Camp Elliott bus over there. This bus is for MCRD. This bus is for men who want to fight.
Okay. He is a polymath. Not to mention, I think he's bald.
Well, you picked the right place, Cole.
Thing that actually happens
a city
in the
that
army,
needed an
like,
honest cop like a thirsty
like,
man
hey,
needed water.
Supposed to go,
you
like,
heard
right
the stories,
got
but you
on
weren't
the
interested.
Boat,
you were here to fight
like,
the good
you.
Fight.
How do you
solve
not
cases,
know
right
where to
wrong.
Go in a foreign country. Go fuck
the
yourself.
Force is like politics. There's no sitting on the fence. You have to choose sides.
Yeah, I would lay down my life for
a
that
brown
guy.
Paper envelope or a Greyhound ticket to Belugaville. They could only ever end one way.
All units at 211 in progress and shots fired at Westlake Savings and Loan. 1415 West 3rd Street. Unit to handle identifying code 3.
We'll take that. It's only a couple blocks from 14 to Adam calling KGPL.
Yeah,
we'll handle the 211.
Roger that. 14 Adam, be advised suspects are armed and dangerous.
Roger KGPL.
The Japanese.
14 Adam on route.
Turn that apron off. We don't want anyone to hear us coming. And we'll drive on the correct side of the road. Check it. Oh! Okay. Someone put a
what are you doing to this car?
I lightly tapped it, my boy. Can I get over this? No. I want to go that way, and I'm annoyed that I cannot.
Slow down!
Alright, first of all, being slow was why it didn't break. Yeah, that's right, get it, fucking break.
Make it quick, you guys, the cops are here, we gotta move it!
That's illegal! Shooting at me, not a great idea! You got back to get shot, gunned, to the face, bitch! Whoa! I did actually shotgun him in the face. Marco! Okay, I'm gonna come out, and if you shoot me, I'm gonna cry, alright? Bear that in mind, alright?
Weapons on the ground, now!
I got it! First try.
George, keep your goddamn head down! Use the cover, Phelps!
And
LAPD, put down your weapons! The bank is surrounded! I'm offering you a chance to-
Chance, copper!
Cut to an... We don't know how many are in there.
I'm slow.
Backup will be here.
Stay down.
I don't know how I'm going to miss it. I'll lift it there and I'll get it.
Go!
Still missed. Blank in the net. You never see it coming.
Stay in cover.
Oh, look at him. It's guts
it.
All over the wall.
We got them all? I think we got them, Cole.
Yeah.
Should be all clear.
No thanks to you, coward.
Lieutenant Hopkins says anytime you reach for the shotguns, you're either going to end up dead or wearing a citation. So I guess...
It's okay, Ralph. You did well in there. I'm glad you had my back. Man couldn't ask for a better partner.
We murdered some folk. It's all good. That's like our job.
This kind of opportunity comes along once in a lifetime, Hank. I have to grasp it.
You have to survive it first, Cole. Here are the veterans. The Japs love to shoot officers.
If I can make a name for myself in this war... My future.
Thinking of taking on a company of the Emperor's finest single-handed? You don't seem the Sergeant York type to me.
When I need your opinion, Kelso, I'll ask for it.
They talk about officers like you in boot camp, Cole.
Oh.
They call it the Custer Syndrome.
Ah, remember?
Guys who go around dreaming of fame and glory and getting all of their men killed in the process.
Our duty is to lead, Kelso.
And their duty is to die for your wonderful future?
He's got us there, Cole.
He's Cole Phelps there. And Jack Kelso. With some people, it's as simple as chemistry. Two guys who should have been friends, but their personalities got in the way. Phelps, a good guy, wound way too tight. And Kelso, a quiet man who could never walk away from a fight.
Well, it's a shame you don't like to talk about it, Cole.
Wow. Ralph. Friends who want to stay friends don't discuss religion or politics. And in my case, you can add the war to that.
I know that bum. Wendell Bowers. I put him away before he jumped parole.
Okay.
Get after him, Phelps. I'll head him off in the car.
Right there along.
Wendell Bowers! Stop! LAPD!
I'm gonna kill you.
By you! He's hiding in the alley!
I know what you're thinking. Don't do it.
Bowers! Hold it right there.
Stop now or I will shoot.
Yeah, you're going to jail.
I won't tell you again, Wendell.
Jesus, Dunn. Watch your fire.
You're shooting at me, bro. Don't worry. I'm getting his ankle.
Count on it right now.
Give it up, Wendell.
Stay the hell away from me.
No.
You've got to be kidding!
You fucking asked for it.
Did I?
There's no way I'm going back inside. I've done my time.
I mean,
it's over, Bowers.
Skip parole, idiot.
You assholes already screwed me once.
Yeah, you're right. We're the problem.
Give it up, Bowers! There's nowhere left to go!
Damn, I thought I could get around the other way.
Looks like we've got the place to ourselves.
Alright, just so you know, the last guy that I had a fight with, I absolutely fucking annihilated him. Like, he didn't even get to swing a punch. And he didn't cheat fucking shot me.
Oh! How you doing, Wendell? Your parole officer's feeling lonely.
He's got a hole in his life for an asshole like you. You can make it up to him in 10 years' time. Watch your head.
Egypt.
This hump will be back in the Iron Hotel by tomorrow night.
And he kicked me.
Nice work, Cole. You run track in high school?
Is that a common thing that Americans actually say to each other?
Part of the tradition of the Marine Corps and being an officer in the Marine Corps is the ability to make tough decisions. The right decision is not always the popular one. The right decision will get the men you care about killed. These ratings and your ability to give them frankly and truthfully directly affect your chances of successfully becoming a Marine officer. Candidate Phelps, you have the floor.
Okay.
Esprit de Corps. Merrill, 10. Franklin, 8. Weiss, 8. Donahoe, 6. Kowalski, 6. Hudson, 5. Kelso, 2.
What is a
leadership?
Expert?
Donahoe, 8. Franklin, 7. Merrill, 6. Kowalski, 6. Weiss, 5. Hudson, 5. Kelso, 1. Candidate Kelso!
I'm sorry, Captain, but I joined the Marine Corps to fight the enemy, not get involved in this schoolboy chicken shit.
Kelso, in my office, now!
Okay. Buyer beware.
For every cop, there's the case that makes you. Gives you that leg up. Gets you recognized as the shining new star in the squad. The case that you solve that shows that you have the gumption, the gung-ho, the get-up-and-go to make you stand out from your average rank-and-file patrolman. This could be the one goal.
Okie dokie. I'm on it.
LAPD, could you stand clear of the body, please? Has anyone called an ambulance?
We've called an ambulance and the police, but I'm afraid he's dead.
Well, are you a doctor? Shut the fuck up.
Okay, stand further back and move along. It's your choice, but make it quick, people.
Hey, Cole.
He's very quick to say
you got here quick.
My
beat crosses 7th Street. Okay. Your first reporting, then. We'll get a perimeter going and move the crowd on. You better see what you can find out before the homicide dicks show up.
I hate dicks.
I'll be with you in a moment.
Broad daylight. A crowded street. I've seen everything.
Everybody stay back. Let us do our job.
He was eating jam. What is this? Seagull getup, pearl earrings, 5250, no tax. Lovely. Martin.
Seagulletta. Layaway receipt. Martin. Pearl earrings. Made out to Bank of Arcadia.
Okay. I mean, they've paid way more than 5250. Oh no, that's the balance. I'm an idiot. Were you killed over $8, sir? Okay.
All right. Yes, it's a dead person.
I had his gun.
FN Browning. Serial number 01138. Might need to run by a gun store.
No problemo.
Eagleson's gun store's a couple blocks from here.
Super. Cool. Roulette.
Shell casings. These look like 32s.
This guy in the crowd thinks he saw something, Cole.
This guy?
You better take a statement.
Answer me then. Bitch. Talk to me then. You gonna tell me or what?
Sir, I'm Officer Phelps. What exactly did you see?
I heard the shots. I thought it was a car backfiring. I saw a girl run at the shoe store.
Okay.
Don't you people have anything better to do?
That's it.
Speak to the witness before homicide arrives, Phelps. If you think she's lying, don't be afraid to get forceful. Verbally, of course.
Sure.
And don't accuse her of anything without proof. Lawyers love that shit. And if you're sure she's straight up, try the general approach. See what you can coax out of her.
Okay.
Can I help you, sir?
I don't know. Can you?
Doesn't look like anything.
I'm Officer Phelps. Hello. Miss, I'm here about the shooting. Did you know the victim?
He was my boss. Mr. Gage.
Mr. Gage.
Mr. Gage's first name.
Everett.
Everett Gage.
You are?
Galleta. Clovis Galleta.
Hey, see Galleta, you're in that thing I found. All right, what did you see? Okay.
Do you think you could tell me exactly what happened, miss?
I look around the shops at lunch. I was in a store when Mr. Gage, my boss, bursts in yelling that I'm late on my lunch.
Well, where are you?
And?
We came back. I was angry. I walked in front.
Okay.
I heard shots. I turned and saw Mr. Gage fall.
Mm-hmm. And why'd you kill him? Mm-hmm. Jacuzzi. I mean, what'd you say? I mean, that's probably the truth, right? She's looking shady. Jacuzzi!
I'm having a hard time believing that, young lady. You want to be taken to a police cell?
You're hardly any older than me. Don't you dare talk to me that way.
All right, you win this round.
A man is dead, Miss Galleta, and it's a criminal offense to lie to a police officer. I ought to take you downtown.
You're going to jail.
Get out right now.
This is a public store. I can be here if I want.
But I won't say another word to you.
Oh, well, that's exactly what I'm going to do. But I am taking my sweet time. Shoes. These your shoes? A size 82, perhaps? Miss
Take a smarter
Elephant.
Man than me to connect that.
Rude to me. Kill you. How about we chat one more time? No?
If you'll excuse me, I'd better get the store closed up.
Well, just so you
we
know
We have how, the murder weapon?
But no murder.
That did not work.
I saw it all, but she clammed up on me. We could trace the gun.
Eagleson's gun store's a couple blocks from here.
Yeah, she was the problem.
Thinking what I'm thinking?
Tate! Maintain the perimeter.
Yeah, Tate. Oh, hold on. I don't want this car. Hold on. I don't want this car. You tried to kill me. I want this car. Get out.
LAPD, police emergency.
You can't do this!
I mean, stop me.
There. LAPD, I need your car, now.
That's the lemon wash whistle.
Beep. I know what you're thinking. Do not
What
give
did
me
I tell you about going too hard on the witness?
I barely
She's
went
a store
hard
assistant,
went,
not a prisoner of war.
Right
is that supposed to be funny?
Went, yes!
I'm just saying that sometimes
anything,
you need to pour some sugar on these broads.
Oh!
A little bit.
Ah!
God damn it, Cole!
And since when are you the expert? We got the murder weapon, didn't we?
You shouldn't dole it out if you can't take it, Phelps.
What?
She was a looker, though. Tell me I'm wrong.
No wonder you're suddenly so...
You gonna leave the street light intact on this block?
No wonder you're suddenly so obsessed with bedside manner.
So you're just excited that she was hot? Maybe you should have spoke to her then, you dick.
Drunk, mister? Or are you just cracked?
Would you just fucking say to me, I'll kill you?
Officers Phelps and Dunn, sir. Wilshire Division. We need you to trace a serial number.
Sure. What's the make and model?
F.N. Browning, model 1922. The serial number is 01138.
You don't say. Well, I didn't sell it. Europeans love them, but it's pretty rare you find one over here. Although I did have one in here a couple of weeks back.
Remember the owner?
It's not that fucking rare.
Callu. Like, Edgar Callu was his name.
He
looks like he'd never been fired, but he brought it in here for cleaning anyway. And he bought a box of cartridges and he left.
You know where we can find Mr. Callu?
Told me he was on his lunch break. Said he worked at Hartfield's jewelry store just up on Broadway.
Okay.
Thanks for your help.
And by that, of course, I mean, thanks for nothing, criminal. Let me go down to your shooting range, now that I know it's a thing. I kicked your bucket! Is it a bucket of bullets? I remember that being a joke from, Arrested Development? I think it was. Halt! Thank you for halting. I'll have your car now.
Sir, step out of the car, please. LAPD.
Thank you.
National News here on KTI.
Go spin ahead, bitch! Oh, was I going too hard on that guy, too? Go ahead and threaten that double off area. Seamless. We got here without a single thing breaking, and we only stole one car. Wait, Quality Meats? The best in town. Sounds like a place to eat.
Officer, can I interest you in a new watch?
You can interest
Officer
me
Cole
in
Phelps.
The truth.
Are you Edgar Callu?
No. Mr. Callu is out back. He said he'd lie down. I'll buzz him for you.
Oh, murder does knock it out of you.
Son of a bitch! Go, Cole, go!
Don't worry, I'll get him. Are you waving at me? Hello!
Callu! Get back here!
What? I'll have what she's having. Excuse me. Oh, I absolutely hate you, boss. I absolutely despise you. Halt in the name of the law! You bet!
Too late, Callu!
I think you're sexy too, if that's what you said. Get out of the
ground! Stop or I will shoot!
That's right. Stay in the street. Lie down.
Edgar Callu, you're under arrest for the murder of Everett Gage.
And for making me run. Do you even know how to run? Look at that fucking smile.
The case that makes you, and the case that breaks you. The one you never solve. The one that keeps you awake at night. The case that gnaws at your guts and ruins your marriage. The case that keeps you propping up a bar as you relive the what-ifs, the might-have-beens, the half-leads, and the half-truths.
Can you
the case
stop
that other cops
so
murmur
negative,
about
God.
Whenever you walk past. The case you never, ever discuss.
Your throat might not have been so
God's mill may grind slowly, but
time.
It grinds finely, son. I hear it's you who nabbed our malefactor from the shooting yesterday.
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh, uh-huh,
then tell me, Boyle. I hear you're quite the climber, a man of initiative.
That's me.
How would you like a chance at smiting this man with the sword of justice?
Okay.
You're asking me to conduct the interview, sir?
I am, young Phelps. You've only been with us a short time, and you've assembled yourself a stellar arrest record.
Yeah.
Not to mention the fine work you did in the war, sending heathens back to the hell they came from.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm curious as to whether you can turn your hand to interrogation.
Yeah, fuck the Japanese.
Takes
right.
A certain animal cunning, lad. Do you think you might be ready for that?
Yes, sir. I think I am.
Good man. You need many things for a conviction, young Phelps. A motive, opportunity,
it is.
Hard evidence, And best of all, a confession.
I thought she was holding a dog.
If you fail in the former, you can always use a modicum of violence to obtain the latter.
You sure I'm the man for the job?
How are you feeling, lad?
Fine, sir.
Very good. The evidence is overwhelming. May the cat eat him and the cat be eaten by the devil. Bring me a confession, young Phelps.
Is that a phrase?
This is your chance. Don't fail me.
Oh, I will, sir.
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
Too bad.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that.
All right. How do you look, murderer? Oh, he's like, oh, I fucking got away with this. Got away with this. Got away with this.
Let's talk about the shooting. Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about.
And yet you run when I just asked about you. I didn't listen. hold on. You're a liar.
You deny owning a Browning pistol. Serial number 01138.
I owned a gun, yes, but it was stolen in a burglary a couple years ago. You can't prove I used my gun on Gage.
I knew that you had it just a couple of weeks ago.
Gage was an asshole.
Pardon?
But his death wasn't down to me. I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles. We're done. Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
Did I choose the wrong thing?
You disappoint me, Cole Phelps.
Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy! I need a confession!
All right. Sorry, Ed, I have to raise your lump, so, wap it out.
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that. Let's talk about the shooting. Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about.
Focus start.
I'm sure my lawyer can clear all this up.
Jackals.
You deny owning a Browning pistol. Serial number 01138.
I owned a gun, yes, but it was stolen in a burglary a couple years ago. You can't prove I used my gun on Gage.
Pokemon BDSM Dungeon? Okay. I will grill the guy. I asked him about... Oh... You're going
you had the gun cleaned and bought a new box of ammunition. The store owner remembers you and where you work.
Yeah. Is that so?
Yeah, he went. He's
it's amazing what the Nebuchadnezzar will call when it suits them.
Giant ears, Dumbo.
What's let's change
your
the
religious
subject.
Motive?
You fasting for Yom Kippur, Mr. Kalu?
Yeah, let's change the subject, you going motherfucker. How about baseball?
You're okay. Not denying you're a Jew, Mr. Kalu.
This is America. It's not Germany. It's not a crime.
Some people don't like Jews, Mr. Kalu.
Yeah, and I guess you're one of them.
Gage hated Jews, didn't he, Mr. Kalu?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I don't either. Hold on. Shakuz?
You're lying, Kalu. I think you lent Gage money, and he owed you payment.
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm done with you. Go flap your gum somewhere else. I want my lawyer.
Okay.
I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles. We're done. Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
I do.
Captain, you disappoint me, Cole Phelps. Hard.
Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy! I need a confession!
I'm going to.
Has my lawyer arrived yet? I want to see my lawyer.
Shockingly, your lawyer, a lawyer is can't still help not you, here Mr. Kalu. Because I still
you shot a man
him.
Dead in cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that.
Okay.
Let's talk about the shooting. Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm sure my lawyer can clear all this up.
You deny owning a Browning pistol, serial number 01138.
I owned a gun, yes, but it was stolen in a burglary a couple years ago. You can't prove I used my gun on Gage.
You had the gun cleaned and bought a new box of ammunition. The store owner remembers you and where you work.
Is that so?
Yeah, that's how we found you.
It's amazing what the nebbishes will recall when it suits them.
Let's change the subject. You fasting for Yom Kippur, Mr. Kalu?
Yeah, let's change the subject, you going motherfucker! How about baseball?
You're not denying you're a Jew, Mr. Kalu.
This is America. It's not Germany. It's not a crime.
Some people don't like Jews, Mr. Kalu.
Yeah, and I guess you're one of them.
Gage hated Jews, didn't he, Mr. Kalu?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay.
You're lying, Kalu. I think you lent Gage money, and he owed you payment.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, to be fair, I feel I'm backing up a possible religious motive with evidence of a possible religious motive. Yeah, and it doesn't feel right, but I'm gonna do it.
I'm
yeah,
done with
it. Yeah,
I
didn't you. Feel right.
Go flap your gum somewhere else. I want my lawyer.
All right.
I've just got to keep my mouth shut and watch you run around in circles. We're done. Unless you want to keep making a schmuck of yourself.
I mean, we're just admitting murder. This is torture for both of us.
You disappoint me, Cole Phelps.
Get back in there and raise some lumps, boy. I need a confession.
Hello, Mr. Kalu.
Has my lawyer arrived yet?
I'm
I want to see my lawyer.
You about the shooting
a lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu. You shot a man dead Gage. In cold blood. You're going to have to pay for that.
Have I played 12 minutes? I have not played 12 minutes. Is
Let's talk about
is?
The shooting.
Is that just hell over and over again?
Do you deny shooting Everett Gage?
Over and over to win?
I'm a businessman. I run a jewelry store. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm sure my lawyer can clear
you
all this up.
You know what I'm going to say, you villain? You know!
You deny owning a Browning pistol, serial number 01138.
I owned a gun, yes, but it was stolen in a burglary a couple years ago. You can't prove I used my gun on Gage.
Can I just ask you a genuine question? When you know what I'm going to say, why lie?
You had the gun cleaned and bought a new box of ammunition. The store owner remembers you and where you work.
Just be like, yeah, we've already been over
there. It's amazing what the nebbishes will recall when it suits them.
All right. I'm going to bad
let's change the subject.
You after this. And you're going to be like, oh,
you fasting
no,
for Yom Kippur, Mr. Cohen?
Yeah, let's change the subject, you're going, motherfucker. How about baseball?
You're not denying you're a Jew, Mr. Kalu.
This is America.
And
it's not Germany.
To feel like I hate
it's not a crime.
I keep going, you're Jewish.
Some people don't
you're
like Jewish. Jews, Mr. Kalu.
You're Jewish.
And I guess you're one of them.
Gage hated Jews,
like
didn't he, Mr. Kalu?
I don't know what you're talking about.
All right. You're going to jail.
You left-wing leaning parasite. You expect me to sit here and listen to your drivel?
You call me that? You sit there and you call me those names, you goddamn goy butt snatcher. You
are
that
stoop
Gage.
Why did you do it, Mr. Kalu?
Gage, he's in the Chamber of Commerce. He's in with all those momsers. He blocked every proposal I ever put forward. Kike this and kike that. He's been trying to ruin my business for years.
Edgar Kalu,
is kike
I'm charging
slur?
You with the first degree murder of Everett Gage.
Because I've said it now.
I respect your beliefs and your right to hold them. I hope for your sake The jury can commute to murder in the second degree. May God have mercy on you, sir.
I hope they give you the chair.
Masterfully done, Officer Phelps.
Was it?
It is just, Officer Phelps. Isn't it, lad?
Yeah, and I assume after yes, that sir. Display, I'll never...
Then let me have a word ever. With the Chief of Police, young Phelps. The department needs heroes. A shining, honest face the public can admire.
I'm sure he will.
I applaud a man with your talent for unwavering justice.
I hear that's all the rage.
Back to your duties for now, Boyle. But here's a piece of advice. Get yourself two suits, get them pressed.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
You'll be needing them.
Just two suits? You know, there's 7 days in a week. What if I get one dirty? You know what, I'll just buy 41. Then I almost have one for every week of the year, but not quite. It's all right, I'm a police officer. We're all paid very well. Plus, I remember we can buy a hog for like $3. So. Inflation sucks. I need frame people just to come. Oh, I will, don't worry. That's exactly my plan. Hello, I'm a detective. My name is Cole, and I'm a detective. I'm here to solve crimes, cause I'm a detective. He almost
stepped on my desk, kid. You're on traffic. The hot sheet is posted here next to the map.
What's his problem?
Mm-hmm. That's Biggs. He's an institution.
So this is what all the fuss is about.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Why couldn't they build a freeway that goes past my place?
They haven't even approved the money yet, kid. The bond issue won't be till December. It'll be years before any of this will happen. Here's your new partner, Stefan Berkowski.
I've heard all about you, Phelps. You go easy on me and let me earn the odd citation, and maybe we'll get along fine. I'm here to learn, Detective. He's an intense one, isn't he, Mel?
Who's intense?
The newly minted detective here,
Hello,
Cole Phelps.
Hi, Roy.
Phelps. I'll be keeping an eye on you. I could spend a little time basking in reflected glory, make a change from busting hookers and dope fiends.
Okay.
Who was that, Commander?
Roy Earle, Chief Detective and Advice.
Do they all dress like movie stars?
Well, Roy is a movie star. And the whole of the seedy side of L.A. is his audience.
What is that supposed to mean?
Stick with me, kid. You'll find out.
He's a criminal. All right, I'll drive.
And now some housekeeping. Warm Central Division welcome for Detective Cole Phelps.
I thought we had a case already, but it's all right.
Some of you guys may know Phelps. He's the cop who broke the jewelry store murder.
Mm-hmm.
Stand up and take a bow, Phelps.
Four interviews and I got...
If it's all right with you, sir.
Order, Phelps. Phelps. Sir.
Ooh.
Shh, quiet, everybody.
Phelps is one of only two serving LAPD officers who received the Silver Star during the war.
And that's just because they don't have
you
a gold star.
Gave it those lousy Japanese, eh, Phelps?
I did my best, Captain.
Why you war heroes always so modest? I've partnered Phelps with everybody's favorite
so
pole, Stefan Bukowski.
Hope you like work, kid. Bukowski sure as hell doesn't.
Well, that's why we have partners, right?
Okay, can it, guys.
Keep your paper.
Stick with Bukowski. He's a good cop. He knows traffic inside and out. I'm going to start you out with one case. You do okay, I'll give you a couple more. You screw up, you'll be rousting vagrants and running license plates. Hmm. Now get down to the P.E. Freight Depot, 6th and Alameda. Patrolman called in a suspicious vehicle. Signs of foul play. See what you can find out.
Ooh, lovely.
Come on, Phelps.
All right, everyone. I'm off to solve crimes and murders and the jazz.
I can take you to the picture.
They really pushed you through quick, didn't they? 6 years on patrol before I got this desk. You were here in 5 minutes.
I
don't
care.
What do you want me to say? I didn't ask for any favors.
I'm very good.
Confessions.
Oh, I'm gonna murder.
There's an oxygen line for you.
I see no exit. Ha! I see an exit.
You know this place?
We don't need that car. We need this car.
Gas works and signal people.
Hey!
I'll direct.
Damn it. Hey! They know. Damn it. Well, can't drive away from me if they're in a car park.
The infantile paralysis fund drive to replace $7.5 million spent during the severe 1946 epidemics. And in New York, little Nancy Drury with the big cop was once a polio victim, but now she's the pinup girl for the current campaign seeking to raise $25 million. Little Miss Drury of Louisville, Kentucky, and her 6'8" escort.
So, tell me a little about yourself, Phelps. Are we friends now, Bukowski? You have to work together. Don't be so touchy.
Okay.
Grew up in San Francisco. My father was in shipping. Went to college at Stanford. Did 2 years ROTC before Marine OCS at Camp Elliott. Shipped out in early 45 as my first lieutenant.
Are you blind?
No, I'm just going way too quick.
So you won the Silver Star. I don't want to talk about it. Now, let me get this straight. You single-handedly killed 40 Japs on this hill in Okinawa. No.
Jesus, Cole!
Came out of nowhere. How was I at fault for that?
His name is Phelps. I read about him in the paper.
The door! Hi, I love this.
LAPD, apologies, ma'am.
Wait,
I'm taking
officer,
this car.
My bag's in there.
Oh, that's all right. Don't worry. I need this one anyway.
You were up there all night, draped in the flag.
Goddamn maniac!
You were up there all night, draped in the flag, knife between your teeth, gun at the ready. You finished? The Emperor, Hirohito himself, leading the charge against you.
I did my part, Bukowski. What did you do?
I kept the streets of L.A. safe for the people.
Yeah.
Am I honestly war-shaming him?
Take it easy!
Up on the roof, officer. He has a mask on his face. I caught sight when he shoved past me, but be careful. I saw him waving a gun.
Unbelievable. A mask and a gun? Not on my watch. Nice work, Stefan.
Give it up now! Make it easy on yourself!
Where did he go?
From me.
Why are you running? I see you.
I'll take you all down!
Murder! Surely he has a mask would have been enough. Yeah, I know, right? Two suits. Now this one has a hole in it. Well, that's justice. We killed him, and he was not given a trial of his peers. I think we can all agree, I'm a hero. I forgot which car I stole, so I'm just going to steal another one.
Out of the car, sir. This
I
is an emergency.
One goddamn thing.
LAPD, I need to take your car.
I feel like the sun and
cooled by the car. You know, this isn't a tank, Phelps.
Oh, can you imagine if I had a tank? I'd be forced to be wrecked.
Jesus Christ! Are you asleep over there or what?
That fence jumped out at me. All peace.
this great land for yourself.
Sturdy,
spacious houses.
In Japan, the Japanese were not a minority. So when you think about it like that.
Perfect for families looking to make a new life in a burgeoning
city. Hey, look out for the pedestrian.
No.
That our prices will put a smile on your face. So call us now. Bradshaw 2250.
Look out!
Alicia, there's Fields, nothing even in the road. You're panicking over nothing, you big baby.
Slow down before someone gets hurt.
I would not have stopped.
That you, Bukowski?
No, it's Cole Feld.
Go on through. Parking lot straight ahead.
I need to get back to work, officer.
The detectives are here now. You repeat to them what you told me.
I did the right thing by calling this in. I'm just a working stiff.
Just give them your story and you'll be all right.
Sounds like a murderer to me. Alrighty.
This is your first case, Phelps. It's okay to admit it if you're stumped.
No, it's my second one.
If you don't know
one.
What to do next, just come talk to me and we'll see what we can figure out.
I'm not going to do that.
Thanks, Stefan. You're okay.
I'm not going to ask for help.
That's getting so much sense to our music.
That is quite correct, fellow Dave.
I'm Officer Hart.
Phelps, traffic. Movements are
what have you got?
On point.
Abandoned car, probably stolen. The solid citizen is Nate Wilkie. He called it in.
Okay.
What gives with the coroner?
There's blood all over the interior. Someone's copped the full Broderick, but no stiff as yet.
We have an owner for the car?
Broderick, and this was before
the car is registered to an Adrian Black, just north of Bunker Hill.
All right. Okay. We'll take a look around.
Cool. I'll keep Mr. Wilkie talking, but don't make him wait too long.
Yeah,
he's the restless type. Nice day for it.
Nice day for it. Hello, can I have a look in the car? No? All right, fine. Don't worry, I'm just a car.
Doesn't tell me anything.
Yeah. A pipe at a murder scene could mean anything. $3. It was $3.20. My apologies. Now I look like an idiot. Adrian Black.
32 years old, married. Sounds like an average guy. What was he doing out here?
Yeah, this isn't somewhere for average people. Married to the Joker.
Happier times, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Any money that I can steal? No? Okay. Hold on, I almost found a clue. Oh, it's the side of the glasses, I think. Okay.
Stenzel glasses. Home repaired, by the look of it.
Do I have enough money for tape and a pig? Bizarre.
Get back here, Phelps. We're not done yet. Keep searching.
That's exactly what I was doing. Searching. Oh, hold on. I found a clue. Instaheat.
The brand name might give us something to go on.
You guys, take your time. No freight rolling through here till we're done. And we're still punching the clock.
All right.
Hey, Flatfoot. You're looking to get rid of that old crate? I'll give you a nickel for it.
Ha! You're under arrest.
I've got...
Can I get in the car?
Victim looks to have lost a lot of blood.
Like all of it? Oh my god. Alright, where's this guy I'm interrogating? Alright, what's your
Sir,
name?
Sir, I'm Detective Phelps.
Name's Nate Wilkie.
Nate. You found the vehicle?
Sure. Saw it just sitting there. Strange place to be parking your car.
That is true.
Figured I'd better take a look. And then I saw all the blood. So I called the police.
Sounds logical. Alright. Tell me about the contents
of the wallet.
By the
car. Was there anything in it when you arrived?
You accusing me of something, mister?
Oh, I'm accusing you of something, mister. Yeah, I am. You're going to jail.
Do you want the patrolman to hold you down while we turn out your pockets, Mr. Wilkie?
Maybe I checked inside that wallet. Mm-hmm. Not that I was going to steal anything.
Of course not.
Maybe I took a look.
Okay.
But there weren't no money in there. Not even change.
Yeah, I had a look too. Don't worry. We're all thieves here. Don't roll your eyes at me. I'll kill you. All right. You know who Adrian Black is?
Do you know Adrian Black, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. That ain't a name I'm familiar with.
All right.
You ever seen the car before?
Are you trying to get the trophies
right? Funny enough, I did.
I am indeed trying.
A couple of nights ago, it was over there in the parking lot. I know most of the cars are parked here regularly, so it kind of stood
anyway.
Out.
All right, do you work here?
Mind if I ask what you were doing out here?
Well, I work for the railway. I was on my way out to the switch and reckon I'd take a shortcut.
Okay.
Did you see anybody else in the yard? Maybe somebody hanging around the car?
Nope. I hadn't seen a soul all day till you boys turned up.
Okay.
We found a steel pipe with blood on it near the car. Do you know anything about it,
yeah,
Mr.
Yeah, like,
Wilkie?
Are you a murderer?
No, sir. I went straight for the law when I saw the car was full of blood.
Seems to be a stand-up guy.
When you saw the blood, was it wet, bright red, or darker like it
How'd
is
it
now?
How did it taste?
Darker, I'd say. Looked dry already.
Okay.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Wilkie.
All right.
We'll
Don't
contact
leave
your employer
the city.
If we need anything more from you.
Hello.
If you have to, I guess. I can't really spend no more time over this.
Somebody's got to inform the wife, Phelps.
You can't spend any more time over it.
Now.
Okay. Coroner.
Doc. Detective Phelps. What have we got?
Don't worry, we'll be seeing a lot of each other. Remember, I murdered that man earlier today.
Victim must be in a very bad way.
Any sign of the guy?
Not unless he's in the trunk of the car.
Nah, I looked there. Alright, let's roll. Can I talk to you?
We're going to notify the wife. You seem to have it under control here.
Yeah, I got this.
You got this. Alright, now let's go steal a new car.
What's going on, detective? Something bad happened here?
But it's a murder, you morons. Is some murder up in here? Of course it did. Let's steal the coroner's car! Yes! No! 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 Coroner's car. Why can't I steal the coroner's car? He's immune to being robbed.
620 Bunker Hill Avenue. You know where that is?
Behind Bunker Hill. A couple blocks north of Central Station.
You're gonna kill someone!
I did actually think we were gonna die there. But it's alright, we're fine.
So, what do we tell the wife?
We play it by the book. There's no stiff yet, so let's see how it plays out.
Yeah, I mean, I've lost that much blood before and survived, so I wouldn't stress about it.
Now look what you've done!
Could be a car theft gone wrong.
I mean,
make Black drive somewhere lonely, then give him a tap. But
Why leave the car?
Well, obviously someone got a little heavy-handed.
Well,
it's the
wrong way around.
Also
suspect
how so, genius?
Just.
Where is Adrian? If you've gone to all the...
Hey!
Slow down!
I wasn't even moving! Thank you.
Where is Adrian? If you've gone to all the trouble to steal the car, and it goes wrong,
so
you leave the body
right
behind, not the car.
I might die.
You got something there, Phelps. It doesn't add up.
I sat down and felt myself just get stuck to the chair. Rope.
You read about the guy on the crossing yesterday?
Christ alive!
Alive.
No, what happened?
Over on Lincoln Avenue. This guy's driving along and his oil light comes on. He stops the car and gets out. He pops the hood and...
He's on a rail crossing.
Oh, you got it.
Ooh, my goodness.
He got his head under there checking the oil, and the Southern Pacific freight slams into his car doing 90 miles an hour. The car came to a rest more than a mile down the track.
What a pointless waste of life.
You'll get plenty of blood and guts and finally...
Landmark. This way? Whoop. Yeah. I mean, how do you not hear a train coming at you at 90 miles an hour?
Try making it to the next intersection without killing anyone.
That was that guy's fault.
You do that for me?
I'm blameless. I'm the victim.
Let's go introduce ourselves. You talk to her, Phelps. I'm no good at this shoulder to cry on stuff.
Okay. The murder weapon.
Maybe. No.
Where are you going, Phelps? This is the place.
Yeah, I know. Just trying to get ahead of myself, that's all.
No use leaving the thing half finished. Be right.
Obviously that, you moron. Bonk.
So the pipe missing from Mr. Black's heater is the same one that killed him. Huh. Seems like the assailant is a little closer to home.
It's the wife. And now we know. She is pooped. Also, do they have a shed and an outhouse? No bathroom, huh? No one ever expects to come to the back door for the police.
What now?
Let's go introduce ourselves. You talk to her, Phelps. I'm no good at this shoulder to cry on.
She actually not only wasn't ready for that, but unwilling to do it. So, front door it is, I guess.
Just a minute.
How rude. How rude.
LAPD, Mrs. Black. May we come in? We have some bad news, and we'd rather discuss this in private.
Yeah, bad news
I'm
is
Margaret
you're going
Black.
To jail.
We can discuss this in the living room.
It's Please ironic we're in. Going to the living room because your husband is dead.
Your husband drives a blue Lincoln, Mrs. Black?
That's correct.
Mm-hmm.
The car has been found abandoned, and I'm afraid there are signs of foul play.
I knew something was wrong when he didn't come home.
Yeah.
We believe your husband may be injured. We found a pipe on the scene with blood on it.
Oh, no! My poor Adrian!
Does the name InstaHeat mean anything to you, ma'am?
Yes, it does. We've just had a new water heater installed.
Uh-huh. Whereabouts, Mrs. Black?
Just outside the kitchen window, at the side of the house.
Yeah, I built it already.
I'd like you to try and stay calm and remember everything that you can about last night. My partner and I are going to take a look around. When you're ready, we're going to have some more questions for you. Is that okay?
Of course, officer. Anything to help secure my husband's safety.
Anything. Murderer!
Well, let's check the place out. Come on.
A fox.
Nope.
A plane.
Nothing significant.
Yeah, I mean, it's more relevant than you think.
Good look around.
Kavanaugh.
There's gotta be something in here.
Who brought this home? Maybe Adrian was a patron. R and I should have an address.
Excellent. Let's see it.
Lie down. Make yourself comfortable. So. Your friend of Courtney's.
Yes, doctor.
He seems very concerned about you.
I have these visions. These blinding visions. I can't get them out of my head. My skull, it feels like it's in a vice.
I'm going to give you something to calm your nerves. I want to take you on a journey. A journey back. I want you to remember the good things about your past. Occasions that made you laugh. Times that made you smile.
Bar. Mm-hmm. This one's fine.
This was only recently installed, not 2 days ago.
8250 for a fucking boiler. Tenure guarantee.
I wonder if someone in the house bought this unit, knowing how they would use the parts.
I think we were about 800 for ours. Pounds as well, so that'd be what, like $1,500?
This must be Adrian's.
That's what I'm saying.
Stencil. So the glasses are a match.
Did I have insurance or something? Not really. I think I might have got a bit of a discount. The whole service is paid 260 for repair. Yeah, well, we were going to be 700 to repair it or 800 to replace it.
My Adrian.
Yeah.
This thing gets more and more interesting.
Nicole Nicole Double X. Yeah, I know, it's not nice. Growing up is learning that things are expensive.
A used ticket to Seattle and a suitcase gone missing. Someone couldn't wait to get out of this house. Separate bedrooms, separate pictures. What gives here?
I'm all right now, detectives.
I don't remember asking.
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Okay.
Phelps, badge 1247.
I need the name of a bar.
I need an address on a Kavanaugh's bar.
I need the address of a bar. I know the
name.
Certainly,
detective. One moment. Kavanaugh's Bar, corner of Aliso and Hewitt, south side of Union Station.
Thanks, ma'am.
Okay. All right, criminal. Okay. Criminal.
We found a receipt in the trunk of your husband's car for a live pig. This receipt was made out to an F. Morgan.
A pig?
Mm-hmm. Well, it was a hog.
Adrian runs
a
tool business. That would be Frank Morgan. God knows what he's up to.
God knows what he's up to. Ah, I wish I could ask the community. Good cop?
What makes you say that about Morgan, ma'am?
He's the foreman at my husband's plant. A very shady character. I told Adrian he needs to keep his distance from the staff. They're always out drinking together.
Unbelievable. What's your alibi?
I think you should come clean with us, Mrs. Black. Your husband is missing, and after our search, I'm willing to call the circumstances suspicious. Can you account for your movements last night?
You're not accusing me, are you? What an awful thing to say! I was here all night, of course, waiting for Adrian to come home.
Mm-hmm. It does, in fact, look like that is what she was doing.
Is there anyone who can vouch for that?
Well, no. I was here alone.
Oh, really? You're not cheating on your husband?
I cooked Adrian's dinner and waited, but he never came home.
What did you make? Is there still some?
Your husband frequents Kavanaugh's bar.
How did you know that?
I pay attention. I'm
Adrian
a cop.
Adrian practically lives there after work.
Terrible. Terrible.
So Adrian spends a lot of time there.
Up until recently, he's been away in Seattle a lot on business.
Oh, on business, in business, in business, on business! Business with Nicole Double X? I bet it's also Nicole Double D. Here
Did your husband tell you where he was going last night?
All he said was he was going to meet Frank for a drink.
He's just telling the truth. Oh. Probably is the truth. Don't fuck me.
So nothing out of the usual, then.
Hey!
He came home early from work.
Now we never have to use initiation points again. Intuition points. Again.
And he went out early, too. He normally never leaves for the bar till about 7.
And every single one of them was a truth.
Was your husband wearing his glasses when he left here yesterday?
Yes, he just bought a new pair.
Huh.
Go on.
I kept telling him to throw those old ones away. He tried to repair them with tape. They looked terrible.
They did look bad. Interesting.
Tell us about the photo of Adrian in the bedroom.
What is there to tell? It's from his most recent business trip to Seattle.
Is it, though?
There's plenty to tell. You just won't tell it. You're lying about the photograph, Mrs. Black.
You're incredibly rude and insensitive.
That is true.
But I guess you know that. I've told you what I know about the picture.
And I said, hey, what a wonderful kind of day. Looking up to laugh and play.
What about Nicole, Mrs. Black? Was your husband going to leave you for her?
I've seen the photo frame.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
He thinks I'm stupid. But women sense these things.
Yeah, with your eyes, because you saw it.
If he intended to leave me, or if it was just a fling. God only knows. I only want to know that he's safe.
Mm-hmm.
We'll keep you informed,
well,
Mrs. Black.
Well, thank you for the help.
Please do, Detective.
But don't lie to me again, or I'll kill you. And run into traffic and get a new car. Hello. Well, volunteer. Well, volunteered.
LAPD, I need this vehicle.
Why do you need my car?
Because I don't want mine. Like, it's not a good answer, but it's all I've got. She was thinking about getting back in there. Do you see that?
Jesus, I'm glad to be out of there.
Mr. and Mrs. Black don't seem to have the happy...
You're a goddamn menace!
I was actually so angry. I am a menace.
He's too scared to divorce her, and she's too much of a shrinking violet.
Take it easy, Phelps. I'd rather get there in one piece.
Okay. Hold on. Hold on.
He's too scared to divorce her, and she's too much...
I wouldn't feel safe in a tank with you driving.
Fair. Alright, I just want you to
He's
know...
He's too scared to divorce her, and she's too much...
Oh! Unbelievable!
He's too scared to divorce her, and she's too much of a shrinking violet to throw him out. If this hadn't happened,
like
they could have stayed... Careful!
Car's on fire.
You think she could have killed?
She sure as hell doesn't seem the type. But stranger things have happened.
Up until then, like, my husband cheated on a car.
I think you're doing this on purpose.
Like, if my husband was cheating on me, I'd probably lie about it. Red light! That's fast, we're going.
Hey, I know you.
No, you don't.
You looking for someone?
Would you recommend the special, miss?
She wants a 5-star goddamn wedding.
Okay.
You know Frank Morgan?
Sure. Frank's your regular. He's a loner in the back.
A loner in the back. He's a loner.
Father hates him.
Frank Morgan?
In his ass.
Me, you dumb fuck.
Cole Phelps, LAPD. I understand you're a friend of Adrian Black.
Yeah, I know him.
Mm-hmm.
Are you aware that he's missing?
No, I hadn't heard that.
tough break.
Okay.
We found Black's car, abandoned in a freight depot, covered in blood. You know anything about that, Morgan?
Hell no. I'm sorry to hear that. I like Adrian. He's a good boss.
Please, don't tell me you actually believe this jerk-off, Phelps.
No, of course not. But I did, however, forget what I asked. Could it be the... Ah, yeah, that'll work.
You're lying, Morgan. You were there.
And you're talking out your ass, detective. How about you prove I was out at that rail yard?
How about the fact that you bought a piggy and it's got your name on it?
You were there, Morgan. We found a receipt in the trunk of the car. It has your name on it. We can call the slaughter yard and nail you on it.
All right, already. That fool Adrian's fallen for some dame in Seattle.
Yeah, it checks out.
He wanted me to make it look like he'd been attacked.
Well, you did not do a very good job, in all honesty. You literally left the fucking note that you bought a pig there. And then painted
so much... cops had their own bars.
Painted so much fucking blood in there that it looked like he fucking exploded.
Well, if it's all the same to you, I'll go back to my drink.
I'm actually trying to ask a question.
Where exactly is Black holed up?
Okay.
No idea. I think he took off for Seattle.
Uh-huh.
I'm tired of your shtick, Morgan. Spill it! Or we take you out in the alley and we knock it out of
Stefan
you.
Stefan loves hold knocking up around people. Look at him.
He's waiting for some money to
He's
come through before he blows town.
An address?
It's an apartment house at the corner of Temple and Figueroa. Apartment number 2.
Super.
I think that's all. Thanks for your help, Morgan. We appreciate it.
Hey, I'm just glad I could help. I love cops.
You're going to jail.
Cuff him, let him go. It's up to you, Phelps. There's no way I'm writing this idiot up.
Arrest him. First of all,
you got Morgan's address?
Second of all,
let's get over to his apartment.
Faked a murder. I ain't letting that slide.
I've met some pretty good liars in my time. People who sound convinced.
Open your eyes!
Have it now?
I've met some pretty good liars in my time. People who sound convincing because they actually believe their own bullshit. The type is clever, hard to catch out.
Frank Morgan is not one of those people.
Nope. No, he is not.
Oh, that's a hill! I can't fly up a hill! Woohoo! I didn't even hit anything. Good for me. You broke my... No, wait. No.
Watch it!
You broke your car. It's the rudeness I can't abide.
Watch what you're doing!
Most informative. Thank you.
Sadness. Hey, I want your car! Oh, darn. It's actually illegal to drive on the tram lines unless you're a cop, so I'm gonna have to take
I'm your sorry, car. Sir. Police Down officer, line, I need your car.
Also, buy a bell.
You don't care who gets in your way, do you?
No. Not really. I almost crashed into the hobo camp. If I could have taken down that fence, I would have.
Can we try to get there in one piece?
We can certainly try.
You have got problems, Phelps.
I love hearing the explosion off camera. Oh, it's so good.
Well, let's check the place out. Come on.
Okay.
Apartment 2.
I think it's between 1 and 3, Stefan. Knock, knock. The GTA sessions would...
Help you, gentlemen? LAPD detectives, Mr. Black. You're under arrest.
Yeah, I get that.
Look, I'm really sorry about this.
Yeah, well...
I never tried to hurt anyone.
I mean...
I just needed to get away from LA.
Yeah.
I won't put up a struggle. Just let me get my things.
All right, but if you do...
Do it! Phelps, go after him. I'll try to head him off in the car. Remember, the gun is the last resort.
Is he up or down? He's up. That is heartbreaking. Why do you say
help
the gun
gentlemen?
Is the last resort? I don't like
LAPD detectives, Mr. Black. You're under arrest. Look, I'm really sorry about this. I never tried to hurt anyone. I just needed to get away from L.A. I won't put up a struggle. Just let me get my things.
Knew it! Phelps, go after him. I'll try and hit him off in the car.
See?
Remember, the gun
you
is
gotta
the
be rude, you're going to jail.
There's no point running, Adrian.
That's rude. I'ma shoot you now.
Mr. Black, get back here right now!
I cannot wait to shoot.
Stop right there!
It's over, Adrian!
Oh, damn, I didn't get a chance to shoot it! Oh, can I tackle him at least? Oh.
Why not just come clean with her, Black? Why the melodrama? I thought it would be easier. No, it just got a whole lot harder. Adrian Black, you're under arrest for conspiracy and fraud. We'll see what the DA has to say about wasting police resources on a wild goose chase like this. You're going
to
lose your wife, lose your job, and probably end up in the big house. I hope she was worth it, Adrian.
We'll abandon a car, run from the police, get my friend arrested.
That turned out to be quite some case, huh?
You're a moron.
Adrian, what an idiot. You got an arrest and a clearance in your first case, and in fine style, too.
I did
well
great,
done, Detective. Efficient investigation technique, good public presence. You keep that up and you learn from Bukowski here, you could go a long way in this department.
I only broke like 8 cars as well, sir. Mr. Clue. Oh, 3-star, that's not bad. We'll get a third suit. Oh, I think I will. Now, it's actually so hot, it's unbelievable. I'm so sad how hot it is. The console's car.
Okay, we're gonna keep this short. I'm already late for the DA. First up, Phelps, Bukowski. We got a report of a brand new Packard abandoned in an empty lot off 2nd Street between Olive and Grand.
Okay.
ER is one Oswald Jacobs says the vehicle was dumped in his backyard.
Okay.
There's a patrolman on site. Get down there and see what you can turn up. Any questions?
Okay.
Good. Get going.
Better go earn our pathetic wages.
Rimsky, O'Halloran. Intelligence has information on a stolen car racket.
That sounds interesting.
I'm gonna make him take me to the pictures tonight.
An abandoned vehicle. You catch all the good ones, huh, Phelps?
Yeah, right?
Sounds like there's more to it than that.
Nobody dumps a shiny new Packard unless they borrowed it without asking.
You don't say. You're on fire with the wrong stuff.
Very funny.
Come on, my intense protege. Let's go save the world.
Oh, I thought that said Coal King. I was like, I am a king. Here he comes. Look at him.
I need a hero. Coming up a hero to be in government. He's gotta be strong and he's gotta be fast.
All right, you hear about Adrian? Brought in Seattle, threw him out. Oops. Wife says she's gonna take him back.
Women generally show more compassion. What are you talking about? Adrian dumped on her. He was humping the...
God damn idiot!
I broke everything.
Pride comes before a fall, Bukowski. Talking from experience.
That was way too close.
Cease fight.
Phelps, traffic.
I'm Officer Houlihan. Cars down the alleyway, detectives.
Okay.
We got a call about an abandoned vehicle?
Yes, sir. The car has flags. Might be some kind of diplomatic vehicle.
Hmm? Has anyone touched this vehicle since you arrived?
No. What flags? And that Jacobs bird over there was on station before I got here.
We'll talk with him in a moment. Give us some time to look the place over.
Sure, take your time. He's a sore-headed old son of a bitch anyway.
Okay. That's a nosy old bat if I've ever seen one. Sweeping her fucking porch while the cops are looking about. Don't think that's anything. What about this baseball? Also nothing.
Circumstantial.
Cool. Alright, can I look at the car? Alright, someone stole the wheels.
Stealing the wheels is for amateurs. A car ring would have stripped it in a warehouse.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Kukowski, you are just right in the way. No plates?
We'll have to use the registration to trace the owner.
Yeah. Missing a flag as well.
You must have taken the flag as a souvenir. Can't have any street value.
This is just
it's owned by the
here?
Argentinian embassy.
What about the boot?
Empty.
Even the missing... Even the spare is gone. Oh, hello.
Seems irrelevant.
Oh, I thought it might be a matchstick. Where's B? Is this B? No, that's not B. A wrench.
Combination wrench. Must have used it to remove the wheel lugs.
And then left their tool? Seems bizarre. Mitchell and Mendo, you may have. You may have. I want to talk to the old bat first.
You better see what this Jacobs guy has to say.
I'm talking to the bat.
Probably dumped in his backyard after all.
Hey, Martha.
I don't know why you're doing that, buddy, but I wish you'd stop.
Oh, really? Am I weird? What you gonna do? What you gonna do? What you gonna do? I refuse to believe that she doesn't have opinions on this.
Oswald Jacobs?
Hello.
That's right.
What exactly happened here, Mr.
The big smile?
Last night, I was looking out of my window. Mm-hmm. I like to keep an eye on what's going on.
I can understand that.
Uh-huh. You see this empty lot? Damn kids play stickball here. Yeah. Always exactly breaking my windows. Always asking for their ball back.
Can we get back to the car, Mr. Jacobs?
Don't be impatient, Sonny. Anyway, last night I see this brand spanking new Packard up on bricks.
You see, no, pal, you are also a nosy old bat, and you're rude.
Hey, I pay my taxes, so do some goddamn work.
I'm going to arrest him.
Did you see who stole the Packard?
Hell yes, I did. I saw three goddamn Mexicans going to work on it.
Can you tell us what they were doing?
Using the headlights of an old Ford so they could strip the thing. Mm-hmm. I yelled out to them, I'll call the cops.
Oh, yeah.
So they loaded up their car and drove off, tooting and hollering and yelling obscenities at me in Mexican.
You speak Spanish, sir?
No, I do not.
Okay, then how do you know how do you know they were swearing at you, idiot? He is a fanny. Like, he's chuffed with himself. Okay.
After the Mexicans left, you didn't go anywhere near the car?
After I scared them off? No, I didn't go anywhere near that car.
You took the flag. He's gonna cry! He's gonna cry! Oh my god! You absolutely stole the flag, man. I've never seen someone who stole a flag more in my entire life. Look at that man! Can I just accuse him of stealing the flag? Oh, look, he's... Dude.
How do you know there were three of them? It was dark. It must be 50 feet from the kitchen to the car.
You telling me I'm lying?
I mean, like, honestly, I don't know how to,
Sorry. Sometimes you have to shake the tree to see what falls out.
I feel like it's probably bad cop, because I don't feel like I can go, oh yeah, then where's the flag? Like, he doesn't... Hold on, remove an answer. Well, that didn't fucking help! I knew he was a liar. Did you take the flag?
You went out to the car. Once they were gone, you had to take a look for yourself.
I was curious. Ain't a law against that. So what if I took a look around that car? You can't be accusing me of nothing.
I mean, like, it's not. Oh god, I actually hate looking at your face. Alright, so they used a Ford.
What exactly did you see them take?
They was working on the tires. That's all that was took.
I can't tell if he's gonna cry or if he thinks he got away with it. The license plate. I'm gonna have to. I think it's probably the license plate, right?
Why did you take the license plate?
Me? Well, what I do with license plates? You saying I have them?
I mean, like, you said that they took the wheels and nothing else. You see, if I was stealing from a crime scene, but I was accusing someone of having stole from the crime scene, I don't think I would go, yeah, they stole what they stole, and not accuse them of stealing what I stole. Give me the license plates.
Scratching what? Around in that book won't prove nothing. You should show me some respect.
Outrageous! Outrageous! You're going to jail!
Tell me about the car they were driving.
It was an old Ford. I didn't catch the license number.
Yeah, it probably checks out, to be fair.
You look like the kind of guy who notices details.
You're right there. The car was old, but it looked brand new. Candy apple red paint job stands out a mile.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Jacobs. You can speak to Officer Thibault about signing a formal statement.
Yeah.
When you get the car out of the way, maybe you could come back and do something about those kids.
Yeah, God forbid.
How about we bring you an umpire's mask?
Play.
Jacobs dumped the book he was reading in a hurry when we walked up. Curious what he didn't want us to see?
Oh, fuck yeah. I reckon this is a racist book, right? Like, I don't know what's in it, but I feel like this is probably a racist book.
Okay, so we have the owner of the vehicle, a degenerate. I'll run John Madsen by R&I.
Henry, nice eyelashes. Stanley, lovely speaking voice. Walter, good nature. Ben, gentle. Teddy, full lips. Jimmy, baseball fan. Simon needs a little coaxing. Likes cherry flavored candy. This man's a pedophile. Angelic features, olive skin, blonde locks, tanned with blue eyes. That's actually quite unique. Tall and lean. Barrel chest. Delicate! Bro, it's not a racist book. It's way worse. Is it worse?
Contact details on a William Dewey. This looks like business rather than pleasure.
Does it? Slim hips. Dark, good looks, particularly shy. Likes gifts, very innocent, very pale. Angelic features, but feisty.
Oh, even his core, even sort of.
I do still need to try and save everyone from the quarry. Yeah, they do. Oh. I'm not giving him that book back.
I think we've run this place dry. Let's find a game well.
We have no comments on that disgusting pedophile book? You need some advice?
I need a game well, Phelps.
I probably cannot help you. What is up, Rain? No, it does not.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247. Could you run the name Dewey Brothers? Why. Possibly a dealership or car mechanics workshop.
One moment. Dewey Brothers Packard Dealership, 629 Figueroa Street.
Got it. Can you put me through to Michigan 2458, please?
Very important.
Connecting you now. Hello, can I help you?
LAPD, ma'am. Can I speak to John Madsen, please?
He's at school, officer.
I have no idea, man.
What's this about? Is he in trouble?
I would just go to any second-hand show.
Boy, ma'am?
Or
just
online.
Just turned 16.
Just go on, like, Facebook Marketplace or something.
Wrong person, Mrs. Madsen. Sorry to disturb you.
I'm not the guy.
Messages for me, please.
I have no idea.
There's just one message for you, detective.
Oh, good.
Order Packard, diplomatic license number, Paul Robert 706. Was reported missing this morning by Juan Francisco Valdez.
Oh, super duper.
Could you have him brought in?
He's already here at Central, Detective. He's demanding an audience, as he calls it.
Thanks.
Can you get a message to Captain Leary? Tell him we'll be in as soon as we can. Thank you.
Okay.
Can you cordon off this lot until we have the vehicle impounded?
Yes, sir, Detective.
Right.
We'll follow up on the owner. Get a statement from Jacobs, and I'll read your report back at the station.
Yeah, I would say so. Can I have this car? Good, I can have this one.
Now we have our boys home again.
Will we go to the Dewey Bros first?
To secure their future. I'm Leland Monroe, and I'm here today to offer you every peacetime soldier's wildest dream. Without new house and land packages, your shining knight can rule his very own kingdom.
He's gotta be first, and he's gotta be first from the top
of Los Angeles. These are modern, elegant houses, priced competitively.
This has gotta be the 50th abandoned vehicle call we have got this year. One more, and I'm gonna go crazy. Not your favorite cases. You kidding me? Barely even police work. Of all the bad guys in this city, we get lumped with the ones who can't even be bothered to keep what they steal.
Fair enough. Have I got the hydrant on me? No. I'm just kissing. Beep beep. Like a glove.
Old empty bed. Brings our
heart in
bed.
You I should have
done it, by the way. Apparently, LA Noir has quite a following on the Switch. Bigger than on just consoles generally.
Take it easy, Phelps. I'd rather get there in one piece.
I have not played the Dredge game. I do know of it. Very important to run over people. It's what I do. It's what I do.
I've been black and blue.
I always try and avoid seeing too much information about games that look interesting, so that when I do play them, there's a little story to find.
Well, now you've either got to stop or put your fucking foot down.
I always put my foot there.
Don't tell me, let me guess. You were making your way past the lot, caught sight of the new model four-door, and couldn't help yourself. You could see yourself in that car and just had to take a closer look.
I mean,
well, I can't say as I blame you.
I can't see myself in the car, but I want you to know I'll probably break it.
LAPD, Mac. We'd like to speak with the owner.
Want to die.
That's me, William Dewey, proprietor at your service.
We're investigating the theft of a Packard belonging to the Argentine embassy. Are you missing a combination wrench?
I don't know, Detective, but I know how we can find out. Follow me.
Following you. Oh, and by the way, I will be stealing a car when I leave here. Hey, new Coca-Cola.
We keep all our tools in here.
Okay.
Mind if we look around?
Be my guest. You sure you guys aren't interested in a new car? Huh? Maybe a used car.
I have some nice used cars for guys in your wage bracket.
Why don't you give us some alone time, Dewey? Go sell some cars or whatever it is that you do.
Yellow first. Why can we not just count? Like, why do we have to solve puzzle? You know?
That's not right.
Of course it's not right. I misclicked your
one wall. Left.
Gabriel Delgado is missing a three-quarter.
Gabriel Delgado, Mr. Robot, Domo. Domo. Found a hammer. We could use this to interrogate
this is going to help
people.
Us.
Be helpful.
Doesn't give me anything to go on.
And it could be the license plate number, huh? Hello. I'm gonna steal this spark plug.
Probably nothing. I doubt it.
Ike.
No good. We need diplomatic plates.
Okay. Oh, I... Okay. I was about to say, have I come to the in the wrong order and fucked it all, but maybe not.
Hi. If you don't mind, we have a few questions.
You're not smiling now, are you, you little bitch?
A wrench from this dealership was used to strip the wheels from a Packard last night, Mr. Dewey. A couple of Hispanics were seen taking parts.
We've had a spate of thefts ourselves. Comes with the location.
Mm.
Thieving bastards will steal anything the minute your back is turned.
Okay.
So that's it?
Like I said, the workshop's too close to the street. It's difficult to keep an eye on it.
I forgot what I asked.
Packards are great cars, but this doesn't look like the kind of place favored by foreign embassies. How do you know Valdez?
I don't know Valdez. The embassy bought the car. All I know is he must know a quality car when he sees one.
Uh-huh. Right. Who is this? Okay, cool. I know you're lying.
And I know a shyster when I see one. You and Valdez are in this together.
Me and Valdez? I hardly know him.
So you said you
Valdez
know him.
Wouldn't wipe his shoes with me.
Oh, really? Is that why you're in Valdez's notebook of pedophilia?
We found your contact details in Valdez's notebook. He had to be calling you for something, Dewey.
Okay. So I met Valdez in a bar. We cut a deal, and he bought the car through the embassy. I cut him some change on the side. It happens all the time.
Okay. Super.
Where can we find Delgado?
I don't know. He sure as hell isn't here.
Okay.
Address, Dewey, or my partner shoves her head in a car door.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
Apartment 3, 103 Hill Street.
103 Hill Street.
And tell him from me, if he ever shows his face around here again, I'm going to kick his butt from here to Kingdom Come.
Okay. Will do.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Dewey.
No problem. God damn that kid. I'm just an honest car salesman. Seems like you just don't know who you can trust these days.
You lied to me 3 times.
Going to movies, Dewey. You're missing your calling. Time to visit Gabriel Delgado. See how good his excuse is.
Can I has? You don't want this car, bro. Wait, why can't I have these cars? I want these cars. Stational paper, bro!
Can we try to get there in one piece?
I mean, he drove into me. That's the thing. Right through the middle like a glove.
You read the story in the Examiner about the Navy developing 3-dimensional movies? What's a dimension? You know, like a graph. Vertical axis is Y and horizontal is X. Well, that's clear as mud. Third dimension would be Z. So, things would be popping out of the screen. That's ridiculous.
Are you blind?
That is pretty ridiculous, to be fair. Damn.
That's ridiculous. Scare people out of the theater. God's name would want that. I don't know. People scoffed at the idea of talkies in color. Look what we have now.
Full speed through a tunnel with my headlights kind of on. I think one of them may be broken. Doesn't make a difference. Missed my turn.
Now look what you've done!
What? Go back to the station? You're welcome. We must have hit that guy.
I have a Juan Francisco Valdez in for questioning.
Sure do, Phelps. Your bird's an interview, too.
Okay.
And get this. He's wearing gloves and doing his best not to touch anything. Can you beat that?
Sounds like we don't want to keep this guy waiting. It's this way.
Yeah, we already have. You say he's in one? One's in two. Okay. Come on.
Are you the senior officer I requested?
Sure, why not?
I'm Detective Phelps, and this is Detective Bukowski.
Have you any idea how long I've been waiting to speak with you?
I am needed back at the consulate,
and you keep me here like a common criminal.
All right, friend, let's take a deep breath and start all over again.
Mr. Valdez.
Consul General. I insist on my full title.
I'm not going to do that. This is the meme guy. Packard purchased.
Where did you purchase the car?
My secretary and driver arranged the purchase. A disreputable place, a Dewey Brothers by name.
Mm-hmm.
As soon as I can have it arranged, I will have my Hispano Suiza brought up from Buenos Aires.
What? Okay. I mean, I'm pretty sure you're lying with the same information I just got on this guy. Like, you definitely know each other. You are Valdez, right?
You're lying, Valdez. You made the arrangements for the car.
Call the embassy. I decided the color and model, but was not involved in the transaction.
If that is the case, then... I mean, I actually have questions about this book, but we'll get to that.
Ya basta! I will stand no more of this!
I'm not happy right now.
Consul General, we have located your car. Can you tell us how it was stolen?
It must have been stolen from the consular garage. Terribly inconvenient, of course. I want the perpetrator... soundly flogged.
Unfortunately, we don't do that here, Your Worship.
Okay.
You have a pretty good idea who stole the car, don't you, Consul General?
Go on,
are you
going to
tell
me,
or do I shake it out of you?
There's no call for violence.
I disagree.
I suspect a disgruntled boy from the car dealership.
Uh-huh.
You have a name for this kid?
Gabriel, like the archangel. I have no surname.
He was in your book.
So tell us about this kid, Gabriel.
Taking them all high ground and flogging.
Run-in with him?
Mechanic.
Yeah. We didn't do that.
A presumptuous young man who did not know his place. He presumed to ask me questions.
We do a lot of presuming here in the United States, Consul General. It comes with the turf.
I mean, I'm gonna... He was in your book.
You fuck young boys, Valdez.
Are you a madman? This will cause an international incident.
Maybe, but I did find your pedo book. So. you know, so, I mean.
Danny, Ben, Miguel, Tristan, and Teddy.
Which one was the one with small
full
pits?
Lips?
You weirdo.
Ring any bells?
I'm sure we can come to some arrangement.
Mm-hmm.
Gabriel, spill
go
it.
Go ahead.
A beautiful but impertinent boy.
Oh, God. Hold on.
I mentioned rendezvous and the young man went quite insane. I thought he was going to kill me. I was prepared to pay.
Mm. We'll be in touch.
You were prepared to pay?
Consul General. Yeah, let's nail this kid Delgado and wrap this thing up.
You're going to jail for being gross. I don't like it at all. I don't like it. Don't be a pedo. That's bad. That's not a hot take either. I'm lost. Looking at me because I can't find the exit. Oh no. It's only my second day on the job, don't judge me. Exit.
Finished with Valdez.
Thank God. I'll get rid of him.
No.
In a couple of hours.
Arrest him. Keep him arrested. Bad guy. Make tummy queasy. Yeah, it could be. Don't see any reason why it couldn't be.
In the air, locked up the barnyard with the greatest of care. Down in the hen house, something stirred when he shouted, "Who's there?" This is what he heard. There ain't nobody here but us chickens. There ain't nobody here at all. So calm yourself and stop that fuss. There ain't nobody here but us. We chickens trying to sleep, and you butt in and hobble, 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 hobble with your chin. There ain't nobody here but us chickens. There ain't nobody here at all. You're stomping around, shaking the ground, kicking up an awful mess.
Hold on,
hold on. We chickens trying to sleep, and you butt in and hobble, 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 hobble. It's a sin. Tomorrow is a busy day.
Oh,
we got
man.
Things to do. We got eggs to lay. We got ground to dig.
Oh,
and
worms
to scratch. It takes a lot of setting getting chicks to hatch. Oh, there ain't nobody here but us chickens. There ain't nobody here at all. So quiet yourself and stop that fuss.
There
ain't nobody here but us. Kindly point that gun. The
take it easy.
Way, and hobble, hobble, hobble off and hit the pay.
Open your eyes!
I just found the best shortcut in history, bro. You're attacking me for it. Fucking pigeons.
Okay, let's see what Gabriel has to say for himself. I just hope our archangel hasn't already flown.
Hello?
Isn't he the captain?
What the hell is this guy doing?
Want another accommodation?
Yeah, pretty great. Knock knock, motherfucker.
Where do you see a number 3 marked on that door?
I mean, I just knocked on the door, to be all honest with you. And how do you know it was number 3?
Here he is. Apartment 3.
That's 4.
Hey, keep it down, would you?
My little girl just got...
Okay, I'll keep it down.
Yet.
You're under arrest.
LAPD, ma'am. We're looking for Gabriel Delgado.
Gabriel?
We're from the police. Policia, you understand?
Yes, I understand. Could you come inside?
That was quite racist.
What is your name?
Ana Rodriguez.
Is Gabriel Delgado here, Ms. Rodriguez?
No. What do you want with Gabriel? Is he in trouble?
Stay where you are, Ms. Rodriguez. We need to take a look around.
But he is not here. I have told you.
Check out the surrounds. I'll stay with the broad.
Okay, cool.
So how far along are you, Anna?
What?
Nearly 20 weeks.
Oh.
Right. So how's it going to be when you go like, to the labor and he's not around?
Oh.
You are wrong about Gabriel.
That is pretty damning.
He's a good father.
Souvenirs are a dumb move.
Hard to provide for us.
Unless you help us here, Anna, your little one won't be seeing Papa for
incidental.
A very long time.
Hey, keep it down, would you? My little girl just got to sleep.
Oh, I didn't even mean to do that. That was just coincidental.
Difficult to tell whether it's the suspect vehicle from the scene. Certainly Gabriel's pride and joy.
Okay, let's destroy it.
Optimistic call.
What? It's a list. Oh, baby names. Gotcha. Yeah, lists don't work. Tell you that with absolute certainty.
This doesn't pertain to the case. I don't think so.
Not with that attitude.
Serving breakfast meals. For two, Anna? You should have cleared up.
Knock, knock, motherfucker. Oh my god.
Diplomatic license plates.
Let's let him done in.
This isn't what we're looking for.
Yeah. Just tools. More
good
tools.
To me.
Oh my god, the wheels.
It looks like Valdez gets his wheel back.
Time to go to jail for harboring a fugitive. Have your baby in jail, 'cause you're a criminal.
You're in serious trouble, Miss Rodriguez.
But Gabriel is not here. I have done nothing wrong.
You and your baby are going down. Right? Going down. Right? I'm gonna ask you this one, because I know that you just had breakfast with him, and I'm fucking livid about that.
Tell us the truth, Anna. Has Gabriel been here?
I haven't seen him for at least 3 nights.
You better hope that's not true, otherwise you're gross. You're gross.
You keep lying to me, and I'll send you and your baby to jail.
He lives here, but he hasn't come home. I swear it.
Enough, Anna. There are signs all over this place that he's been back.
Yeah, there's breakfast.
He was here last
night.
That's
it. That's all I got.
I have never seen him so angry. Mm. He went out to his shed and put some things in it.
Yeah, I've been there.
I don't know what, and I don't want to know.
Okay.
I love him.
Mm. You can love him from afar when he's in jail, and so are you.
Why did he steal the car, Anna?
The customer insulted him. He has his honor, no?
Oh. Oh, right. Okay, well, that's totally fine then, huh? I actually think, perhaps... Let me do that again, surely. Okay, cool.
He steals cars to support you and care for the baby?
How can you say that? What makes you say that?
I mean, the wheels?
I have my own job. I work at Union Station. If I have to, I will bring up our baby.
The accusation felt like a different question.
That is all I have to say to you.
Okay.
We found a license plate matching our stolen vehicle in the shed. Add in the assortment of parts, and we can make Gabriel for a dozen other thefts. It's time to get serious, Anna.
You must ask these questions of Gabriel.
Mm-hmm.
I know nothing of these car parts.
You're lying, Anna. I think you're a willing accomplice in these robberies.
What proof do you have that I stole the cars?
You didn't steal the cars, obviously. You got the fucking, flag on your table. This is frustrating.
Looks like I made a mistake.
I'm gonna accuse you of the flag.
You come into my house to insult and bully me?
Yeah, pretty much.
I have known many policia like you.
Gabriel wasn't at work. Where can we find him?
He said he would never go back.
Mm-hmm.
Gabriel is out driving around in his car.
Oh. You know, I believe you're there.
If you don't tell me where he is right now, Anna, I'll put an APB out on him and ask them to shoot on sight.
Please. Please don't kill him. I can't tell you anymore.
As soon as we corner Gabriel, we'll be back for you, Anna. You had your chance to cooperate.
You're under arrest.
Let's get out of here, Phelps. Don't worry. I've got an idea.
Oh, super duper. Because I was stopped.
Never understood it. The more rotten the boyfriend, the more loyal the girl will be.
Uh-huh.
She's going to warn him, Phelps. We need to follow her. You've got a pretty funny idea of what keeping a low profile means, Phelps.
Mm-hmm. Shouldn't have taxed it.
Easy call, better back it off.
Thank you.
son of a bitch.
Now would be a bad time to forget how to drive, Cole. Too close, Phelps. Way too close.
Yeah, I appreciate that, but now I'm reversing in a street, which doesn't feel less suspicious. You know what follow missions need? Cruise control. They need you to be able to, like, just knock it into a certain speed, hit cruise, and then just carry on. You know? What? No, she didn't. Bullshit. She saw that, but not me reversing halfway back up the fucking road. Bullshit.
Never understood it. The more rotten the boyfriend, the more loyal the girl will be. She's going to warn him, Phelps. We need to follow her.
Officer needs help, 103 and Beef.
You've got a pretty funny idea of what keeping a low profile means, Phelps. Be a bad time to forget how to drive, Cole.
Hit me, man.
Requesting assistance at 1st and Santa Fe. Reports of an illegal street race.
Stay on Delgado.
He's getting away.
This green car is throwing the entire race to fuck with it. And he just crashed the car. Insane.
Step on it, Phelps. Take him out.
I'm on it. You know what?
Delgado is our boy. Forget the others.
Come on, you're getting creamed by a kid in a red Ford.
Damn.
Gonna lose him.
I mean, we're not gonna lose him. Oh my god, why is there barrels in the water? And broken car. What the hell is this thing?
Lay into his wheel arches. Come on.
Yeah, I mean. Well, if he didn't have a fucking turbo, it would be easy. I missed.
Enough games, Phelps. Take this guy out.
Okay, hang on. Do you not have a gun?
God damn it, Cole, hold it steady.
Fuck. No way.
Gabriel Delgado, you're under arrest for Grand Theft Auto.
Fuck you, puto! You should speak to the maricón! Valdez, I shot him! Now who's a man? I should've burned his fucking car!
Okay. No,
you got a foreign dignitary outed as a fruit and a kitty raper, a car dealer we're gonna let slide for the kickbacks, and a street punk car thief who sure as hell won't be taking liberties with other people's autos.
Yeah, I know,
again
but he's a bad guy.
That Detective Phelps is not a bad haul. You keep your chin low and your hands high, and you keep bringing me clearances just like that one. That's textbook policing, and we need more of it in this department.
Okay. Did I mention I arrested a pregnant woman? Because I did that too. That's not bad. Argentinian consul gets his packard almost in one piece.
You have any plans for weekend liberty, Jack?
My sisters have been working in Los Angeles in a bomber factory. They're coming down to visit. Super. I'm meeting them at the station at 6.
Good for you, Jack. Are they cute?
They're my sisters, Hank.
Attention! Final inspection before liberty.
Why am I more important than people that came in on our... Like, aren't we at the same level?
Good job, Kelso.
And I... Yeah.
Are we going somewhere, gentlemen? Full inspection! And it better be exceptional if any of you want liberty this weekend.
Like, what the fuck? They just had an inspection, yeah?
Kelso, this carbine. The bore is dirty.
No, it isn't.
Are you arguing with me, Kelso?
Do what you need to do, Sergeant. You know the bore is immaculate.
Weekend liberty canceled. 2-day field drill.
Clean this rifle.
No.
Do you know the penalty for insubordination, Kelso?
Jack, don't do it.
Forget him, Hank. He doesn't have what it takes.
Are you two finished?
Are you going to clean this rifle?
No, Sergeant. Cole is right. I'm going to stop playing games and join a rifle company and fight the real enemy.
Like, there was just an inspection that went, good job. And then they have another inspection where they say it's fucked? Like, I don't understand how that's possible. Oh, Lord, hang on.
Hey,
fire oil.
All right, gentlemen, I just got this handed to me. A hit-and-run felony at Ray's Cafe, 208 North Los Angeles. Got a patrolman on site. The coroner's on his way. Get down there, see if you can find any witnesses who can put a make on the car.
Yes, mouthpiece sir. Strips off me at the grand jury case.
However, we are going to do that.
Now the DA wants my head.
Next time. Also... I'm going to put on a new suit, because why not? And yeah, thank you very much for watching. We will continue La Noire soon. Tomorrow, there will be a couple of streams. It'll be Dead by Daylight later on in the evening, and during the day, I might try and bash out some Life is Strange, because to be honest, considering it's Pride Month, I have not played Life is Strange. And that's like the Pride game. So, well, the games I've played anyway. But yeah, thank you very much for watching, and I will see you tomorrow.